Hello students, today we are going to learn the poem Past, Present and Future. It's written by M.B. Bronte. Let's have a look over the poem first. Tell me, smiling child, what the past is like to thee? An autumn evening soft and mild, with a wind that sighs mournfully. Tell me, what is the present hour? A green and flowery spray, where a young bird sits gathering its power to mount and fly away. And what is the future, happy one? A sea beneath a cloudless sun, a mighty, glorious, dazzling sea stretching into infinity. Poet Emily is talking about three time periods, that is, past, present and future. In the stanzas, the poem is a conversation between the poet and the child, where the child is comparing his life with seasons, namely autumn to his past life, spring to its present time, and the summer season to show his future life. So come along, let's have a look over the poem and let's enjoy it. If we'll see the first stanza, the poet is asking to the child, Tell me, smiling child. The poet is asking to the smiling child, the happy child. And the poet is asking to the child that what the past is like to thee. Thee is an old English expression used for pronoun you. Means the poet want to ask child what the past was like to it. And the child replies it, an autumn evening soft and mild, with a wind that sighs mournfully. Means an autumn is a season where the tree sheds its leaves. It's gentle. If we'll see the meaning of sighs means with a pain, a soft humming sound, and mournfully means a sad feeling. So similarly, the child also has a same kind of past in his life, that having some sad moments. Let's move to the second stanza. Tell me, what is the present hour? A green and flowery spray, where a young bird sits gathering its power to mount and fly away. Here in the second stanza, the poet want to know about the present time of a child, means what is its life in present time. And the child replies, a green and flowery spray. It indicates the spring season, where greenery is everywhere around and flowers falling from the tree. All the trees get new leaves and flowers. It's beautiful season and the child is also very happy. So the child wants to be like a bird, a young bird, a small bird who is sitting gathering its power, who is trying to collect all its power to mount. To mount means to climb and fly away. You want to collect all the power. So similarly, the child also want to fly high like a bird in the sky to explore the world by gathering all the knowledge, skills and the talents he has and want to make a name in the world. Let's move to the last stanza of the poem. And what is the future, happy one? A sea beneath a cloudless sun, a mighty, glorious, dazzling sea stretching into infinity. Here in the third and the last stanza of the poem, the poet want to know about the future life of the child. So the poet is asking, what is the future, happy one? How is your future gonna be? And the child replies, a sea beneath a cloudless sun. My future will be like a sea. Sea means an ocean, which is beneath. Beneath means underneath. A cloudless sun. Cloudless means the sun is not shaded by clouds. It's cloudless. It's clear sun. And where his future gonna be? Mighty. Mighty means strong, glorious, happy, dazzling, going to shine brightly. And stretching. Stretching means going beyond the infinity. Infinity means endless. So accordingly, the child want to achieve an endless things in its life. So here the poet expresses how its life gonna be in its